Hi, in this video I want to show you how I made one of these little baskets. They all use the same size of cardstock. It's a 6 by 6 piece of cardstock. They're just scored and folded a little bit differently. The first one we're going to make is the easiest, which is this one here. And then we're going to make this one, and last one would be this one. This one opens this way, and it has a message inside. It says hugs and kisses, and it has a hug and a kiss. And then you close it like this, and there you have a little purse. Let's get started. In this video, for this little basket, my main goal is that you can make the baskets, not so much the decoration of them, but how to make the actual basket. I have a template, and I'll show you. This is my 6x6 cardstock, and this is Whisper White, and you're going to score at 2 and 4, and then you're going to turn it and score at 2 and 4. You could also score at 2 on all sides. Then you're going to make 2 cuts, and it's just going to be from here to the center score, and from this one to the center score, and the opposite side the same way. And then you're going to add sticky strip or score tape to the corners, the inside corners, I guess. I'm going to go ahead and round all 4 corners. Then I'm going to go ahead and fold my scores, make sure they're pressed down with my bone folder. And I'm going to take my paper snips and I'm going to cut up to the center and up to the center, then flip it and cut up to the center. Okay. This is going to be your basket like this. So this is the inside of the basket, and I'm going to add the designer paper to the outside. You're going to need 5 pieces of designer paper that are 1 7/8 by 1 7/8, and 4 of them you need the whole thing, and 1 you're going to cut in half, and you're going to add each of the 4 to the outside squares, and I already rounded the corners of those as well. And then the halves, this is the opening, and if you look at it, this is how the basket is going to be. So this would have to go at the bottom, at the bottom of the one that is cut. Okay, there you go. So now the score tape. You can use sticky strip from Stampin' Up if that's what you have. You can even use glue, like a white glue. So I'm gonna add my tape to the 4 corners, the inside corners, these 2. one there, and one here. Then I'm going to take my handle, and the handle is a piece of white cardstock that measures 3/4 inch by 7 inches, and the designer paper measures 5/8 by 7. Mine is a little bit shorter than 7. I was running out of the designer paper, so I made it just a little bit shorter, but it doesn't matter because that's going to be in the inside. Then I'll take my fingers and kind of run them across the entire piece of cardstock just to make it a little bit softer for the handle to fold easily. And then I'll take more score tape and add to the bottom. You know what? Let me see. Actually, it goes in on the back of it. Sorry about that. The one that the little square basket that we'll make, it goes on the back. I mean on the front. But this one, it goes on the back. Okay, so you're going to take the backing off of that. And you're going to add this to here, to the center square, leaving about 1/4 inch, I want to say, between the designer paper and the beginning of your handle. Okay, then you're going to take the backing off, and then you're going to make them meet in the middle. And then do the same on the other side. Take the backing off and make them meet in the middle and press. Now for embellishments, I stamped the heart with real red ink on white, and I punched it out with a 1 1/4 circle punch. Then I punched out a red circle with the 1 3/8 circle punch, and then I punched out of the white cardstock a scallop circle. This is the 1 3/4, and I added the red to the scallop, and then the white stamp image to the red with dimensionals, and then I pierced every single scallop. Then I added some score tape on the back of this, and I'm going to center this on the basket. And there you go. You just need to add some crinkle paper that you can buy at the store, or you can make yourself, whatever works for you, and add some candies, and then you can give it to friends and family. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you liked it. And if you have any questions or any comments, please let me know. Thank you.